This is the Star Wars content I'm looking for. Oh wow, this is such fabulous news. Let me just fangirl out for a moment before we get down to business. But wow, it has been a slow summer for movie news. The whole summer, really. Especially after Comic-Con was a bit of, well, actually, a significant freaking letdown outside of course, Marvel's presentation. And if this is the kind of headline the D23 has in store for us, well, that next weekend, it's gonna be wild. I've set aside my whole schedule. I'm covering it like I covered Comic-Con, but hopefully there will be more to cover. But wow, I wonder, you know, maybe this seemed to have leaked throughout the day and the deadline confirmed it. I guess maybe this was something they were hoping to surprise everyone with at D23, but maybe we'll get more details because we have absolutely no details as we're about to discuss. But yes, I am personally and professionally thrilled that Ewan McGregor is returning as Obi-Wan. Something fans have been begging for, and what seemed like the obvious creative move to anyone since Disney acquired Lucasfilm. But thankfully, it's a role that McGregor has only aged into over all that wasted time. Do I wish it was a movie? Of course I do. But as priorities in Hollywood shift and Disney is spending $120 million on The Mandalorian alone for Disney Plus, I hope The Mandalorian's good. We're probably going to get a trailer next weekend, but I'm like, all the Star Wars shows they're discussing, it's the one I'm the least excited about. But it's, of course, the one we know the least about. So again, hopefully we'll be pleasantly surprised. Oh, but boy, I want this one right now. So maybe if they're spending that much money on The Mandalorian, we will get plenty of lightsaber battles and force use in an Obi-Wan Disney Plus series. Only now, with heaps of character development on top of all that. I mean, even if it's just 6 episodes, which is the low end of streaming shows, that's still a trilogy right there, time-wise. Oh my god, I can't wait. Now, again, as I said, there are no details at all available, right? I mean, even if you're, like, a little upset with Star Wars right now, or very upset with Star Wars, are you still not excited about this news? A lot of people have been upset with Disney lately, but this is one heck of an olive branch. Now, we still have to see what the number of episodes are. We have to see who the showrunner is going to be, what the talent is that's involved. And we don't even have a title, right? Now, I have heard, why did it become a Disney Plus series and not a movie? Well, I've heard from my sources that Solo was such a flop that it spooked Disney. You know, they're not only taking a little bit of a pause with the movies as they've announced, also, you know, the theme park ain't doing so good. I've been really careful not to jump the gun on that assessment, but when they start cutting hours of cast members, and I heard that Olga's Cantina has now shortened hours, that's like really weird. I think that they know they have a problem here. So they've decided after Solo that they're going to make all their spin-off movies. Remember, they were going to alternate between episode, spin-off. Well, all the spin-offs were going to Disney Plus, which has resulted in some really exciting Disney Plus shows. Now, for the movies, I'm hearing that the distinction will be, because they have the same size budgets, the distinction will be that the movies will be more epic in scope and focus on ensemble casts. But I don't know. It's going to be really hard for the movies to compete with character studies of such fabulous characters. I love Obi-Wan, and I'm a big Cassian Andor and K2SO fan. I love those guys! If anyone's done the VR experience, it's at Disneyland and a couple of other void locations, it's real good. And it, of course, features both those characters. And as I said, these competing Disney Plus shows have the same size budgets. I'll be curious to see, you know, Marvel's having the same situation. You know, how thin is the line between Disney Plus shows and movies? And since the Disney Plus shows are longer, will they perhaps emerge as superior? That would be so weird. What a weird time that we live in right now. You know, as we've always discussed, many of you getting angry with me, you know, movies have still always been the ideal place for your content to be or for talent to be. And as I've said myself, you know, still with television, what's the biggest compliment you can pay it? That it looks like a movie. But I don't know. Disney Plus could be the real game changer here. Now, let's see what Lucasfilm comes up with for the movies. Again, that's a big question mark. They haven't revealed anything. All we know is that maybe Benioff and Weiss are doing that their next trilogy. Johnson still claims that he is. I don't know. They both now seem like horrible choices, right? And it's weird because Benioff and Weiss not only are more famous for their small screen work, right, than they are their film work. I mean, film work's actually quite bad. But again, they, as I just said, they messed it up, so I don't know why. I don't know why Lucasfilm is forging ahead with them. I don't know why Netflix just paid them hundreds of millions of dollars to potentially make people even more upset. But again, as I said, we're in weird and confusing times. Now, will an Obi-Wan show do well? I'm inclined to say yes, because, again, it's what everyone wished upon a light-speeding Millennium Falcon for, right? But with the way things are for Star Wars right now, and considering what they did to Han Solo, how they messed that up, I mean, they had the right actors. Even Alden Ehrenreich, I believe, found Han at the end of the movie. I mean, it was unfortunate that people... Well, he was in the middle of a really bad movie, but I think it was cool to see Han emerge through that story, and I loved his repartee with Chewie. They had a good buddy movie there at the heart of it, but the handling of the characters overall was an absolute mess, like how Han Solo gets his name. I hope that's not canon. Can we get rid of that, please? And of course, it infamously resulted in the firing of Lord and Miller when Kennedy decided to protect Star Wars legacy scribe Lawrence Kasdan, who's clearly lost it, and his son in the arguments over the script. So let's see who the showrunner is for Obi-Wan. I think that'll make a very big difference. And then even McGregor isn't foolproof when it comes to interesting and getting an audience interested. I mean, his Fargo generated zero buzz, even though he was playing twins and he got a Golden Globe for it. Still, nobody cared. And his box office resume is all over the place. But at the very least, we'll be getting a whole new bunch of memes and GIFs. And, you know, he does really love Star Wars. Ewan McGregor genuinely loves Star Wars in the role. And I think that should help and is really going to be nice to see. Although everybody, I think, enjoys, well, they did enjoy a big paycheck and being part of a big franchise. But now since it's kind of like a giant hate magnet, I don't know how many people are keen to be a part of it still. But Ewan McGregor, he's going to bring a lot of love, and I think he's going to be met with a lot of love as well. I'm excited. Please don't ruin this, Disney. So what do you think? Share your thoughts down below about Ewan McGregor not only returning as Obi-Wan, but for the small screen. Be sure to hit that subscribe button, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.